be dating.
Your camera, I'd rather your focus be on that only. So grab me a few snapshots down this alley before we all walk down here, because we get weird light anomalies down here. Once we get about halfway, I'll tell you what's going on with this place.
Here, let me hold that.
Got a couple? Smelling potatoes. Y'all catch the irony there? Alright, so we'll stop here for a brief minute just to kind of give you guys a history of this location, and you guys should know what this place is. Anyway, a whole lot of tourists come down here, because, I mean, this is considered a quiet area, by the way, because of the hotel, so that's why we're going to keep your spirit box down low, whoever has it at this point, because I know you guys keep switching out. But this is Lodge Alley. That last crosswalk coming over, that was where the original Charlestown wall used to be. This used to be Charlestown, the walled city. And then they changed it to Charleston. So this is one of the first streets we ever had. So
this
right here. People used to live here. These two giant buildings you guys are looking at weren't here. Little tiny shotgun houses. I have the full list of residents of every person that ever used to live here. There's not a whole lot of them. Only about two pages worth, because there's only about 5 to 7 people that lived here at a given time. Common names I get are Benjamin and John. Did you get any names?
Yeah, Russ.
Russ. Don't think there's going to be a Russ on that list from the 1800s.
Russell?
So, possibly. It might be more of a last name than it is.
Okay,
so again, but again, right. Getting Russ out of a Russell last name would probably be a stretch, and I would probably omit it.
Yeah.
Sorry, professional. I got this.
No, really, I'm sorry.
So the other cool thing about this particular alley, they did do an archaeological dig on this place, and they did classify these people as lower class. It makes sense, because the other part of the wall was going south across the street on East Bay. The smell of low tide would have been coming over that wall, coming right down this alley. Found some of their tools, found some of their silverware, pieces of their clothing. Definitely lower class folks. This is called Lodge Alley, because this is where the Freemasons had a Masonic lodge. Again, Lodge Alley. Makes sense now? So we get words like bricks, Freemason, Mason. I've even had Illuminati show up here before.
Wow.
I know, pretty cool stuff, right?
But the
cool thing about the names that I normally come up with, they usually come exactly the same names that I get all the time, usually about once every 4 to 6 weeks, and they come on different spirit boxes. Benjamin and John, they both lived here in 1801. I don't find it irony that they both lived here. I have a Benjamin and a John. Sometimes I get John's last name, which was Johnson, John Johnson. So again, very interesting. Every once in a while I'll get a third name that'll pop up in the same night, the name Jane. Again, 1801. That's 3 out of 5 people that lived here during that time frame. I don't think that's coincidence by any stretch of the means. What's going to happen from here is we're going to walk through the rest of this alley. We're literally right on the cusp of where tour guides are allowed to go. So we're going to go to our next spot quietly. Keep your spirit box audible to you only. I'm going to stop my video. I'm running it right now just in case anything wants to pop up out of this. I'll stop the video. We'll stop thermal until we do our final investigation at the Powder Magazine over a female pirate. But we're going to stop at St. Philip's Church and Cemetery first. I'll go over some legends and lore. Normally I get a little bit of a rise out of you guys with female pirate. It was like, hell yeah, let's do this shit.
Right?
But
that's what I was thinking.
Okay,
yeah,
I'll take it.
I don't know
telepathy really well. So,
not yet.
But at the same token, the myths and legends, if things pop up out of our spirit box, and we're going to keep it down on mute, but the word list is usually what I go by. You're going to see much larger tours in that area. You guys already know they're allowed to go to 20, so we kind of pick our spot and just stay out of their way. You guys join the annoying group tonight with all your blinky lights and gizmos and gadgets. So again, we stay out of their way. Understood.
Can I ask a question?
ones you're expecting are the ones that could have lived down here.
Correct.
Or
unless somebody comes up to me and said my grandpappy's name was Samuel.
Okay.
And then we have another clue that says pipe or cigar because he smoked.
That's what, okay.
Again, right. I look for double clues.
Got it.
So there was a Samuel that lived down here, by the way, and it was just a name that popped in my head.
Okay.
But that was later on. Later than 1801. But anyway, don't have the list memorized. They should, though, right?
But if that we see that list later, we could then, my point was that there could be names that
I'm gonna give it to you.
Associated with all of us.
Could
that
be.
Okay.
So the list that pops up there, again, I've had people email me weeks later after they finally had a chance to look at their data from their tour, and they said, my cat's name is Radar. The word cat and radar showed up
on
the list in order. So, like, I can't make that stuff up. I don't know you guys that well.
You don't know if we have a cat named Radar?
Right.
Yeah,
so,
right.
Again, when somebody gets back to me that way, that's somebody else that they brought with them, letting them know that they're there. That
yes.
They are giving them a clue, like, hey, I know your cat's name is Radar. Let me give you some more clues. And I don't know what else she found, but I'm sure she dug through the spirit box recording and found a whole lot more.
Yeah.
I've had tours where I brought vets on the tour, and everything was about who they lost overseas. It doesn't matter what story I told. It just didn't matter.
Right.
So, and it's happened. Again, I never know what's going to come up on me. That's
right.
Why my tours are, every one of them is different.
Yeah.
That's why I'm like, I'm going to tell the same shit I tell every night. We'll
right.
see what happens. I can't
yeah,
guarantee.
So, right. We get to see everything that comes up on
you get all of it.
On everybody's
everything.
Device.
Okay. So, I mean, and it's a lot of data. Again, it's, I mean, even with just down to five of us, we still have most things running. The only thing that I took from them and now I'm not running, they don't record anyway. So, again, everything else that records is still going. I'm still going to check the millimeter from time to time just to kind of see what's going on. But let's go through the neighborhood and get up to that cemetery and see what's going on up there. And you can cut that off once we exit the alley. Kind of give your hands a break. Yeah, it's not easy. Dark corners in here.
Mm-hmm.
So you have, like, over there, I know that's the dumpster area, but I mean, even up in these corners are going to be dark.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, you're just the camera person, nice and slow. So if Dean starts getting some little bit of spikes on his, you want to basically be filming relatively in that area.
Okay.
So, again, he's got kind of like the go-to meter. Everybody should be watching Dean. That's why I'm going to follow up with him constantly.
Okay.
Like, after you told
me. Yeah, definitely.
But again, once I get you guys checked in real quick, I'm going to be bouncing around with everybody. But I mean, just record. Also keep in mind, this camera is really high tech. The files for this are large. So after 9 minutes and 26 seconds, it resets into a new file. It's nothing paranormal. It's just at that 9 minute 26 second marker. It'll go into a new file. So if you see a little flicker on the screen, it's nothing paranormal at that point.
So what is this I keep seeing?
That is actually just from the sanitation that I put on there.
Oh,
so
right.
Let me just wipe it off so you don't have that crazy dot. And
I
you're
saw it over there too, so it wasn't too far.
Like I said, I sanitize everything. Perfect.
Okay.
But yeah, have some fun with it.
So I'm just not really looking for anything. It's just going to pop
can,
up.
You can, but it's going to be much easier when I send you the video.
Okay.
So right now, you're the camera person.
All right, thanks.
You're welcome. looking for the purple dots. I'm looking of what's in the darker areas, because this is giving me the long range, this is giving me short range. So again, if my hand comes in the front, it's going to bleach it out. So I normally shut that off, so that way it doesn't bleach out and I can make it out. But again, it is, you're just a camera person at this point. This is a 1.5-inch screen, it's kind of hard to watch. That's why I put it on YouTube for y'all, so you can watch it on your TV, or you can just watch it from my website. However, you know, which way you want to do it. But again, we're going to slice all these videos together.
Necessarily. I mean, if you want to, you can.
Okay.
It's recording.
Yeah. Is there anything I'm supposed to stay away from? He said I could do this for you. Oh yeah, that's a cool picture, Mom, with the turn. She wanted. Whatever. I'm all about science. I used to do autopsies and all kinds of cool stuff, so yeah, now I'm all about it. And now I'm a government contract financial analyst, so go figure. That's what I went to college for, though, was to be a cytotechnologist that then morphed into pathology and, you know, like, probably something with computers.
I walked away from a six-figure income.
Really? Because
I said retail management for over 20 years.
Really?
And I said, you know what? I've got 3 pieces of paper. I said, I can pitch it way better than everybody else.
Wow. That's cool. Yeah, that was your hobby almost.
Yeah.
Or what you enjoyed. Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Action number 8 will be out at the end of this year.
Wow. And I wanted to do a ghost tour.
Okay.
I saw you online and sent it to Keri and
okay.
was like,
check this out. She was doing the itinerary for our weekend.
Sure.
And that's when she contacted you. So it was kind of twofold, we both. But the whole weekend is to celebrate Mom's birthday.
Oh,
so
happy birthday.
We all live in different states, and so we
gotcha.
Met down here.
That's like me and my brother, we both live in Kansas. From Ohio.
Oh, yeah.
My brother
Kentucky.
Lived in Kansas.
Yeah, I lived in Kansas for a while, yeah.
And
I get
obviously
it.
Obviously, I live down here.
I've yeah.
Been down here for about 10 years.
Oh, wow.
And I got a sister that still lives pretty close to Mommy. Well, they were here.
Where at in Ohio?
Youngstown.
Oh, I have to go through there to get to my hometown in North Kentucky. But
from Pennsylvania.
And Keri lives right outside of Denver.
And I live near Lexington, Kentucky.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Wow, all over the place, huh? Mm-hmm.
But we're all from Kentucky. They just...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I migrated. I mean, I lived in Myrtle Beach first for about 4.5 years.
I love Myrtle Beach. It's where we used to go when I was in the 80s. Like, growing up, we would go on the weekends. Near Charlotte. So we would go to the beach all the time. No, it's my first time. Okay, so we're not driving, we are Ubering it and just spending the day. Is there a still way that you can have restaurants plus like walk around and is there shops and all that kind of stuff, or is it more residential is what we were worried about?
With Isle of Palms.
Mm-hmm. Oh, got it. Okay.
So it's kind of like, that's one of the, like, it's a small,
is it more upscale, like, or? Oh, that would be cool. Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Really? Wow. Wow. That's awesome. Yeah, good for you. Yeah, no, that's great. The year before, 2 years. Saving. Is it not to be? Thank you.
don't know till after he looks at it.
You'll see, like if you see me, it should be hot, right?
No, I don't have the hot one.
Oh, well, that's not right.
No,
then.
No. This just videotapes.
Really?
Yeah. The girl over there in the brown seat has the hot one. You're supposed to keep walking around.
one, unless of course there's a William attached to it. That